In the year of the dragon, in a world beyond the realms, I, like all the others, awaited the birth of the dragon of whom the prophecies foretold. But the Dark Master heard the prophecies as well. I should have hidden the eggs long before, but I thought we were ready. I thought they were safe. Oh, how I was wrong.
Save them! The Dark Armies have come!
May the ancestors look after you. May they look after us all.
Eventually, the egg came to rest in a distant swamp, where a family of dragonflies gathered round, wondering what magnificent creature could possibly live inside. They didn't have to wonder for long. What emerged from the egg frightened them at first, but finally amazed and astonished them.
8, 9, 10. Here I come!
It was a purple dragon, who they eventually adopted and raised as one of their own. They named him Spyro, and he grew up alongside Sparks, the young dragonfly who was born the same day. In fact, the two were almost like brothers, and a more oddly matched yet compatible pair of brothers the world has never seen.
Never catch me this time, purple boy.
As for Spyro, he, like all of us, accepted the world into which he was born, believing he was one of them. A big purple one of them, true, but one of them, nonetheless.
I see you, my little glowing friend.
Seeing and catching are two different things, a big boy.
Yeah, you better run.
What's the matter, little Spyro? You can't fly? Oh, that's right. You walk everywhere. That's too bad.
You're toast when I catch you.
Ah, must be tough to lose all the time. All right, let me out of here, you overgrown fungus. Spyro, seriously, lend me a hand here, will you, brother?
Geez, Sparks, I don't know. Frogweed's gotta eat, too.
Spyro, whack it! Do something! I'm your buddy! My wings are getting moldy. Ugh, now I smell almost as bad as you do. And that's pretty bad. See you later, sucker!
So much for gratitude. Hey, that's cheating. We're not allowed in there.
Excuses. Catch up or give up, Chunky.
Now, where's that little gnat gone now?
Has everybody seen a giant purple thing around here? I seem to have lost mine. You know, this is getting a little boring.
Sparks!
I thought all you guys was gone.
Miserable coward, let me go!
Don't let him get away!
Let me out of here and fight me like a thing, whatever you are. You pathetic wretch!
I've heard about enough of you!
Sparks, look out!
No! Was that fire, dude?
Take care of him! I gotta report to Sender!
Get me out of here, Spyro! I think my wings are singed!
You okay?
You almost torched me, dude. Wait. You breathe fire! So I'm just about ready to blow the top off that place and kick that guy's booty when Spyro let loose with some serious flame, dude. No joke. Flames from the mouth.
Well, I was just trying to help.
Oh, some help. You nearly turned me to ashes, dude. Mom, Dad, you should have seen him. He came out breathing fire, all right? I tell you, it was crazy. You don't believe me. Spyro, tell him.
Well, it's true, Dad. I swear. I just got real mad, opened my mouth, and whoosh, Flame City.
It's not that, Spyro. I believe you both. It's just that your mother and I knew this day would come.
What day?
The day when we would have to tell you the truth.
So that was the night that Spyro learned he wasn't a dragonfly after all, but in fact an exile from an unknown distant land.
So, you mean I'm not your real son?
You are our real son. It's just that you came from somewhere else. Far away, where wars rage on, and the innocent seem to always pay the price.
It wasn't long after that night that Spyro decided to venture forth and find his home.
So that's it, huh? Leaving Sparks behind the old homestead? Not a care in the world. Don't look back.
This is your home, Sparks. But I just found out that my home is out there somewhere, and I've got to find it. Besides, I'm not leaving you behind. I'm just leaving you where you belong.
Well, I thought I belonged with you, because I'm always with you. But I guess I was wrong, huh? I'm sure. I'm wrong on a lot of things. You know what? You're right. I'm wrong.
Don't worry about him, Spyro. You know how hot-headed he can be. You'll see him when you get back. Now, son. Keep your head up. Your nose clean, and use that breath of yours wisely. All gifts come with a price.
Don't listen to your father's preaching, Spyro. Just be yourself. It's all any of us can do.
So, hard as it was, Spyro left the only family he had ever known and journeyed on to where he did not know.
Spyro, so me and the old man were chatting, and this whole belonging thing, you know, came up, and we decided that best friends belong together, even if one of them is purple and does have some weight issues.
Weight issues, huh? Well, at least I've never been turned into a lantern.
Oh, please, lantern schmantern. Let's see what's out there. Breathe, Sparks, old boy. Go to your happy place.
What in the world was that?
I have no idea, but I'm going this way, far from it.
Which brings us to the moment that Spyro's journey really began. When he and I finally met again for the very first time. Oh, it's a long story.
And I thought you were a big one. Goodness.
You're alive. But it's too late. Too late.
Too late for what? Who are you? Do you know me? Where do I come from? What are you? What are we? What am I?
You mean you don't know?
Does it sound like he knows?
You're a dragon. When you were just an egg, it was my job to protect you. It was my job to protect all of you.
There are others?
Others? There were. There were four of us. Guardians, that is. And we had one job. Ensure that all the eggs were hatched. It was the year of the dragon after all, and our very survival depended on those eggs. But the temple and grotto are now gone. Overrun by...
Temple? What temple? Can you take me? Can I see it? Where I came from, I mean?
No, no, no. Who knows what forces occupy the temple now? What state it's in? You don't understand. After they came for you.
They? Well, who is they, and why did they come for me?
Because the prophecies spoke of a purple dragon. A dragon born only once every 10 generations. You.
You? Does that mean him? Wait, this guy, Spyro, some special once-in-a-purple thing? I think you might mix that one up. Whoa, that's a little bit of a stretch. I've heard some doozies in my day, but that takes the cake.
Spyro, is it? Well, Spyro, I assure you that I'm telling you the truth. The Dark Army's attacked, intent on destroying the eggs and killing the rest of us. And they nearly succeeded. And then they lay siege to the other islands. We were at war. For many years, we fought all over the islands. Brutal clashes with the armies of the Dark Master, who was intent on preventing the prophecies from coming true. The other three Guardians and I led our small but valiant forces into battle after battle against our ruthless, mercenary foe. And when we were beginning to turn the tide, Cinder came.
Cinder?
Yes, Cinder. Cinder was... is... monstrous, horrific, ferocious. Black dragon that fills the skies with terror. An unstoppable force of nature.
Yeah, you had me at ferocious. Listen, sounds like that thing that was chasing us, Spyro.
Yes, she still searches for me. And years ago, I watched as Cinder plucked the other Guardians from the fields of battle, like so many ripe grapes from a vine. Without them, our cause is lost. Only I, Ignitus, managed to escape. Not that it matters. Cinder now rules all, and I sit here wondering what might have been, what else I might have done.
Wow. Sounds fun. I want to hang out with this guy.
Yeah, why have you given up? I just find out that I'm this special dragon, and you tell me all is lost? That I have no home or family left? I've come way too far to give up now. I want to see where I come from.
Hold up, Savior Boy. Were you not listening to this guy? He's talking about flying dragons and war and horrible... This is bad stuff, all right? I don't know if we're hearing the same thing.
Yes, Spyro. It's not as simple as that. It's true, the prophecies spoke of a purple dragon destined to put his stamp on this age. But the prophecies didn't foretell the devastation that surrounds us now.
Maybe you're right, but I'm willing to try. I want to take the first step.
You're actually going to go along with this lunatic?
Very well, then. We'll go. You deserve to see your beginning. before it all ends.
Am I the only one sane here? He's telling us we're doomed, all right? That's when I go, maybe we should, you know, go back to the forest with the flowers and the fun stuff.
Cinder's soldiers must have knocked the other two statues out of place. Heathens.
What other two statues?
On the other side of this door are two statues just like these. When all four statues are positioned correctly, the door opens.
Yeah, good. I was never good at geometry, so what do you want us to do?
Spyro, I need you to get in there and move the statues in place.
Me? How?
There's a small tunnel that animals use to access the caves. Find it and use it.
Yeah, animals are... Okay, you know what? You do that, and I'll wait here. Hey, when in doubt, break it, right? Go nuts.
Any trouble?
A little insect trouble. Nothing I couldn't handle.
Little insects? My tail section.
The past is prelude, tomorrow a dim promise. Allow us entrance, do not reject us.
Are you making that up?
It should open for us. There is a disturbance. It seems my fears have been realized. They desecrated the interior as well. Guess we'll have to open it the old-fashioned way. Make your way through the connecting rooms, restoring every statue you can find.
Hey, you know what? Let's don't and say we didn't. Why don't you do it?
You want my help? Very well. Hop up.
All right. The old guy's coming to life.
Careful, Spyro. Cinder's forces are surely on their way.
Oh, goody. Hey, Spyro, what was that about?
I don't really know. I just felt like I had to hit it. And when I did, the power of 1,000 suns surged through my body.
Right. Okay. Well, you know what? You should really sleep better. You know, I'm gonna stop bugging you. You really need to get 8 hours.
Forget I said anything. Let's go.
That's quite an entrance, young dragon. There might be hope for us yet.
What are these things?
These are spirit gems. A gift from the ancestors.
What kind of gift?
A gift that speaks across generations. A gift that empowers you with the spirit of the past, strengthening you with the wisdom of the ages.
I feel more powerful already.
Do you hear that?
What is it?
Exactly what I feared. Look, Spyro, perhaps we should turn back.
What? After coming this far?
If this door is closed, it means there are intruders behind. It's how the temple protects itself.
Yeah, it doesn't work too well, does it?
So, what are you saying, Ignitus?
What I'm saying is the only way the door will open...
Don't say it!
...is if the intruders are kicked out of there.
Didn't I just say don't say it?
Well, Ignitus, we nabbed your guardian buddies, but you managed to escape our clutches. Until now.
Stand back, Spyro, and let me show you what a dragon trained in the ancient ways can do.
Whoa, the big guy's got some moves.
Yeah.
Are you okay, Ignitus?
Yes. As I get older, it takes longer to recover.
You are incredible, Ignitus. Can you show me how to do that?
Patience, young dragon. Soon enough, you'll learn all I have to teach. But right now, you must fight. If Cinder's forces were here, there would certainly be more of them in the temple.
Oh, goody.
They won't be there for long.
Wonderful, now he's getting cocky. Spyro, we're not in Kansas anymore.
What happened here?
This is what Cinder has done. Put all the islands under her iron rule.
I wanted to see where I came from, but I didn't know it was going to be like this.
Yeah, no offense, but this place is a bit of a dump.
This was once our home, Spyro. Together we can make it our home once again. Reclaim what's rightfully ours.
What do you mean?
I mean that my time for heroics is past. But with your help, we might be able to beat Cinder.
I can't, Ignitus. I just learned what I am.
You can, Spyro. You can. You are a purple dragon. A very special creature. You've given me hope again. And now it's time to give hope to all of them.
I'm not sure what help I can be, Ignitus, but I'll try. I'll try.
Good. That's all I can ask. Now come with me. I have something for you. The style you used earlier is crude, archaic, and obvious. But you got the job done. Not bad, considering you haven't been taught anything about what it means to be a dragon.
Thanks, I think.
But if you're going to have a chance against Cinder and her army, you're going to need to learn a lot more.
Oh, good, school.
Unlike any school you've ever known, young friend. Now it's time to unleash the true dragon within you. Each of the guardians is master of an element. I, as you may have surmised, am master of fire. Pay attention, and you may be someday too. Let's begin.
So what's with the pool, big guy?
If you must know, Certain dragons have the ability to see visions, the thoughts, memories, and dreams of others, and to see what's happening in places far, far away. I am one such dragon, and in this pool, the visions come forth.
Oh, really? Is that so? Okay, what am I thinking now? What am I thinking now? Okay, now. Now. Now, 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 now.
I'm afraid it's not that easy, Sparks. It takes time, reflection, and patience. What I do see in the pool of visions is that Voltia, one of the Guardians, is being held on Dante's freezer. Spyro, while I look for details on the others, I want you to venture there and find out what you can. Remember, just look around. If you encounter Cinder, run. You're not ready to face her yet.
Okay, so when people are trying to kill me, I run? Got it.
But, Ignitus, how do we get there?
I'm glad you asked.
Why are you smiling? I don't like it.
Let me get this straight. You're saying that I can fly?
Maybe you've been hanging in those caves a little too long, old man. Spyro can't fly, we all know that.
Yeah, a bit of fresh air might do you good. I've never flown in my life.
It's you that will be getting some fresh air, Spyro. Now, close your eyes, take a deep breath, and empty your mind. Yes. Yes, that's it. Now feel the power of your ancestors coursing through your body. In times of crisis, they will come to you and teach you, unlocking powers you never knew you had.
Boy, this I gotta see.
Just forget everything you ever thought you knew. Forget yourself. Only through forgetting will you remember what your ancient blood already knows. You can fly.
Are you kidding? He's flying! Welcome to the club, big guy.
Would that be the annoying pest club?
No, smart aleck, the flying club.
Yeah, I could get used to this.
Dante's freezer is a desolate Arctic expanse that's littered with the machinery of war. Soldiers and weapons frozen forever in the posture of destruction. You must find Voltir before he's lost forever.
How the heck do I land? Coming in too fast!
This doesn't look good.
Incoming!
That's gonna hurt. Nice landing, Ace.
Yeah, maybe this flying thing ain't for me.
Well, it sure doesn't help that you're carrying all that weight. You know, throw a salad in every once in a while. You might be okay.
Yeah, I think I'll stick to the ground for a while.
Good idea.
Not exactly a friendly place, huh? Wonder where we should start.
Well, I'm no hero like you, but maybe we should take that clearly marked path that leads to the interior? Is it weird that that blinked at me?
Just keep moving.
Ice Cube's alive! Why don't we use this thing to knock that bad boy down?
I knew I brought you along for a reason.
You think that was Cinder?
I sure hope so.
What?
Well, if it wasn't, it means there's more than one giant evil dragon around here.
Oh, yeah. I hope that was Cinder, too.
Thank you.
Look out! Spyro, you okay, buddy? Woo! I guess so. Maybe we should head this way, genius. Hey, oh, check this out. Echo!
All right, my turn.
Hello!
Hello.
Who's the genius now, Echo Man?
Hey, that's him. We did it. Bye.
I don't like this. It's too quiet. Too easy.
What part was easy? Getting chased by frozen madmen and gorillas?
Sparks.
Is that what I think it is?
On the miraculous, incredible, stupendous. A dragon your size defeating that thing. Thank you.
Spyro.
A purple dragon named Spyro. Amazing. Of course, there were unsubstantiated rumors of a purple dragon countless generations ago, but most considered a hearsay. Gossip, legend. It's hard to believe, difficult to fathom, amazing to comprehend.
No wonder they gagged this guy.
So much time has passed. So many things have been learned. And now here he is standing right before me.
Excuse me, Mr. Vault.
What is it?
Sir, shouldn't we get going?
Oh, of course. But where to?
Well, back to the temple.
A friend of yours is waiting?
Ignitus?
Yes, Ignitus.
Of course, much to tell him. Many hypotheses to pose, I believe.
Yes, Voltaire. It's good to see you as well. But we don't have time to waste on sentiment. Back to Cinder. She was doing what to you?
Cinder's a chick?
Oh, it's hard to be absolutely sure, Ignitus. But it seems she was using me as some sort of suspended organic power source.
Huh?
She was using him as a battery.
Why didn't he just say so?
Not only that, she also left with a glowing yellow orb. And I believe that I somehow powered it. Does this mean anything to you, Ignitus?
Perhaps. What I do know is that we need to rescue the other guardians before Cinder can power any more of those orbs.
I agree, Ignitus. But first, I'd like to impart some useful knowledge to Spyro. Vis-a-vis his recently acquired electricity-based exhalation device.
What?
Well, he says he'd like to teach me some things about that electricity breath.
Oi, why didn't you say so?
Spyro, Cyril, the Ice Guardian, was taken to Tall Plains. You and Sparks must go there at once and find him.
Yes, sir.
But if we see danger, we should run, right?
There are times when all of us need to stand up to danger, young Sparks.
Yeah, maybe next month, next summer, perhaps next year.
Just go. Now.
Yes, sir.
Tall Plains was once home to a proud ancient tribe called the Atlawa.
Oh, bless you.
Sparks.
The Atlawa were a people in tune with the rhythms of the seasons, focused on their relationship to crops, their surroundings, their gods. They've all been driven underground by Cinder and her forces, who have taken over the tribe's shrine. I sense that's where Cinder is keeping Cyril, trying to power another crystal. You must find him before she succeeds.
Right.
Never easy, is it?
Nothing worthwhile ever is.
So now you're spouting wisdom, hero boy?
Come on. The enemy of my enemy is my friend.
Does that mean what I think it does?
Yeah, we've got to help him.
Oh, brother.
Watch it, would ya?
I was just trying to help.
Well, the Etlauer and Kane need no help.
Oh, just about to spring into action, huh?
Forget this guy, Spyro, come on.
What did they want with you, anyway?
It's none of your business. Now move. I've got a tribe to save.
Oh, you're welcome.
We're going to have to use the water wheels to move ahead.
Oh, it's never easy. Yeah, I know the guy's an ingrate, but you gotta do something, and fast. Buddy, you're getting weirder and weirder by the second.
You again? Why don't you get out of here and leave me in peace? I'm the boss here, nobody else.
Boss of what?
Shh, you're all alone?
Only until I kick these bums out. Which reminds me, I can't stand here chatting with purple dragons and mosquitoes.
Hey, whoa, who you calling a mosquito?
Besides, it's not safe for you here.
Oh, concerned about our welfare now?
No need. We can take care of ourselves. Anyway, we need to get to the shrine.
You'll never make it. The Shrine God has not been appeased since Cinder's forces came. He is not happy.
So is anybody fun around here?
You can't possibly face the God of the Shrine alone.
Not all of us are loners, Kane. I'm not going alone. Well, maybe someday you'll learn that two heads are better than one. Even if they are pinheads.
Yeah, what?
I have to admit, you've done better than I thought possible.
Ah, saying that had to hurt.
More than you can imagine. There are some things you should know about the shrine before you enter.
And I think we're done here.
Not before we rescue Cyril.
The Etlauer Shrine has been desecrated. And the god of the shrine has not been given tribute since Cinder's forces arrived. But if you can subdue his anger, the balance will be returned, and my people can come home.
That's fine, but I came to free Cyril.
You must go through the god of the shrine to free him.
Knew you were gonna say that.
Be careful. Remember last time.
I know, but Cinder left and I don't see any Ice Kings hanging around this place. When things look good, run for the hills!
You have subdued the god of the shrine, restored balance to seasons, the land, our world. The Etlauers want to worship you now.
Worship? Okay, now that's what I'm talking about. I've never gotten the respect I deserve, the praise that should be mine.
That's very nice, Kane, but we have to get back to our home. Figure out how to stop Cinder for good.
My dear Alawas, I am the Mighty Spark, Scourge of the Despots.
Yes, yes, old boy, we'd like nothing more than to stay and be a part of your primitive barbaric society, but duty calls, duty calls.
If you must, you must. But know that you're now part of the Atlawa tribe. One of us.
I am the Mighty Spark... whatever.
By the way, you were right.
About what?
Maybe two heads are better than one. Even if one of them belongs to an annoying mosquito.
Mosquito me? Is that... oh.
Yes, yes, Voltier. I see that months of tortured captivity have done nothing to slow that electric tongue of yours from incessantly wagging.
It's just that it's all so exciting, exhilarating, enchanting, enthralling, and...
All right, no more thesaurus for you, pal.
All of you, please be quiet. It is certainly encouraging that Spyro has been able to free two of you to allow this reunion. But haven't we forgotten someone?
Yes, yes, of course. Terrador.
Precisely. Now, how do we proceed?
I believe I can help, Ignitus. Well, young chap, since you learned a few things about ice on tall plains, I suggest we adjourn to the training room so that I can teach you some more. The legacy of the great ice dragons of yore. My ancestors, who come from the best of the best of this somewhat bedraggled lineage, is long and storied. With my help, rescuing Terrador should be a certainty.
Your pomposity, arrogance, and pretentiousness is odious to the extreme.
Shall we? So what exactly are you saying, Ignitus?
Yes, your hypothesis is an intriguing one, but it is perplexing to the extreme.
Huh?
He says he doesn't know what he's talking about.
Dude, I never know what he's saying.
What I'm saying is that Cinder is harnessing the Guardian's power to unlock a portal that must never be opened.
Why? What's behind this portal?
That doesn't concern you right now. What does concern you is getting to Munitions Forge and freeing Terrador before she can create another crystal from his powers.
And before the volcano blows,
That's enough, Voltier. There's plenty of time. Plenty of time.
Plenty of time? Well, we need more time to have horrible things happen to us? Why didn't we just stay in tall plains? Oh, I'm a big deal there.
Quit complaining, Sparks. Maybe there's a tribe on Munitions Forge you can save, too.
Yeah, but there's always something special about the first tribe you save. You know?
Munitions Forge is an island dominated by Boistbink, an unstable volcano that makes life on the surface very dicey. The locals who live underground have been forced to mine the metals that Cinder uses to forge her army's weapons.
But what are the locals called?
They're called Man Whistles.
Right. I need to write that down.
Rumor has it that Cinder is holding Terrador somewhere in the mines. We know she's using him to power the last of the crystals she needs to open the portal. Free him before she gets the chance.
Boy, is it big.
Boy, it's big. But no time for sightseeing, Sparks. Time to get serious. Let's go.
Not again!
Man, he is small.
What's that? Who's there?
It's me, Spyro.
And the former god of tall plains, Sparks.
You don't carry the stench of Cinder's beast, so you must be friends.
We are. And who are you?
I'm Molière, leader of the Manwer Smiles. But I'm not much of a leader anymore. Those of my people who aren't manning for Cinder are holed up in their caves, scared out of their little wits, waiting for Boistbink to blow. Which shouldn't be long. If you would help me free them, perhaps there's something I could do for you?
I don't know. We're here to rescue a big friend of ours.
Is he a Mate Dragon?
Yes. Why?
Because I know where he's being kept. in the mines near a large labor camp, where my own brother, ex-humor, turns away. We can help each other.
Well, which way do we go? What should we do next?
Oh, it's simple enough, but we've got to hurry. Buzzet Big is getting more unstable by the minute. We must clear these caves before we can help your friend.
And you're asking him for directions? Wow, talk about blind leading the blind.
Forget him, Moyer. We're in.
Oh, you did it! You did it! 1,000 thanks!
It was nothing.
Hey, no problem, pal.
Well, you did your part. Now I will do mine. Your friend is being kept in the center of the volcano, past the labor camp where my brother, ex-humor, is working. Find him and let him know we're friends, and he'll tell you how to proceed.
How will we know, ex-humor?
Yeah, all you manner wee smalls look the same to me.
Oh, you will know him. Trust me. He's the most cantankerous, hard-nosed man we're small around. Whatever you do, don't get on his bad side.
I bet you can't ring that bell.
Why would I want to?
Oh, you're scared.
I'm not scared.
Oh, the big special dragon is scared of the mean old bell. Oh, I didn't know that. I'm sorry. Oh, no. I'm sorry, baby. Why don't I get your pillow you laid out? Spyro, can you hear me? Are you okay, buddy? Hey, listen, forget about those cracks I made about your fatness and your being purple and stupid and fat. All right? Just get out of there, please, Spyro. Don't be dead.
Did you say something?
Me? No. No, I was talking out loud, thinking of my day I gotta do.
Well, just thought I heard something before I blasted my way out.
Oh, that's funny. Yeah, no. Must be hearing things.
Come on, you worthless waste of flesh, let's go! We've got to hop on steam and get back to that flea-bitten dragon. The crystal should be almost ready, and the volcano's right on the brink.
Come on, Sparks, we've got to catch them.
How to drive this thing?
How hard can it be? It's on rails.
Oy, famous last words.
Wait, wait, wait! We're on your side!
More likely spies for the conductor, or that flying beast, Cinder.
No, Molière sent us.
My brother is alive?
He sure is, pal. He's all safe and sound. But I gotta say, he's the friendly one in the family.
I'm sorry. In these dark times, one can't take chances. So, Molière is alive! Oh, wonderful news! But why did he send you here?
Well, he said you might be able to tell us where our friend Terrador is.
If he's a big dragon, I certainly can. The majority of the Manwir Smalls are kept here in this camp, forced to live above ground and mine for cinder. And there are rumors that your dragon friend is being kept somewhere inside, in the darkest pits of the volcano. All of us are doomed.
Not if we have anything to say about it.
What do you mean?
Yeah, what do you mean?
I mean, we're going to free the Manwer Smalls, venture to the darkest pits of Boyzit Big, and find Terrador.
Then, it's off to karaoke.
I see you two crazy kids found each other.
Yes, at last! Thanks to you.
We're just disappointed you didn't leave any fun for us.
Maybe next time. So now, which way to Terrador?
That way, but be careful. The conductor and his maniacal locomotive will surely be close by.
When you say be careful, does that mean try not to die? I'm trying to do that anyway.
Pamax humor. We must get all the Manwer Smurls underground, where they belong.
Yes, it won't be long now.
Is that Terrador?
A big dragon being held prisoner in the center of an explosive volcano? I'm guessing that's Terrador.
Careful. It's never this easy.
After the last two times, you're not gonna get an argument from me, Chief. Oh, here we go again.
You're a little late, fella. The crystal's already charged and the volcano's ready to blow. But before it does, me and Steve here are gonna take great pleasure in running you down.
Purple Dragon lives.
He's got a name, you know.
Yes, my name is Spyro. And you must be Terrador.
Yes, yes I am. And I must say, I never thought I'd live to meet you, Spyro.
Look, I'd love to sit here and hug everybody and chit-chat, but how about we leave before the volcano blows us up?
You're right. I've got to tell the others what Cinder is up to.
Let's go. I'm right behind you. Actually, I'm right in front of you. Look, when the guy says run, I think he knows something.
Go, Spyro! Fly like you've never flown before! I'll go back to the temple for help!
Got to find them. Help Ignitus.
They're gone, Spyro. There's nothing we can do.
I don't care. Ignitus wouldn't leave me.
Spyro, he's right.
I'm right? Oh my god, that's a first.
Yes. You'd never find them in this mess. And you're not ready to face Cinder yet. Time to fight will come, but it is not now.
I guess you're right. Let's go. It's my fault. I failed Ignitus when he needed me most. It's just that the sight of Cinder so close just...
Made your heart stop? Put ice in your veins? Scared the crud out of you?
Yeah, something like that.
All warriors feel fear at one time or another, Spyro. There's no shame in that.
Yes, it's a proven scientific fact that the quotient between adrenaline and trepidation...
Voltaire, please. I believe our good friend here was trying to make a point.
Thank you, Cyril. What I was going to say is that all warriors feel fear, Spyro, but only the most valiant among us can face that fear and master it. From what I saw of you on Munitions Forge, you are one such warrior. Young dragon, now is the time to complete your training. Now is the time to face your fear. Come,
Am I the only one still petrified?
You've done well, Spyro.
Yes, yes, pat on the back, good going, all that other rubbish, but we've got to get moving here.
Oh, Cyril is terribly obnoxious, but in this case he happens to be right, Terrador. Ignitus is the final piece to Cinder's puzzle. If that last crystal is powered, the portal will open and we'll all be done for.
I know, I know. When I was on Munitions Forge, I overheard the conductors say that Cinder's final preparations would take place at her lair, where she lives in solitude among the clouds and the towers. I am certain that's where she's taken Ignitus.
We have to go. Come on.
I'd give anything to go with you, young warrior. But that crystal sapped the last of my will. I fear my fighting days are over.
Every generation must pass the torch to the next, Terrador. Our time is done.
Yes, it is Spyro's time to shine. Now go to it, young dragon.
Yes, sir.
Wow, you guys make even me want to face Cinder. Did I say that out loud?
Cinder's lair is where hope goes to die, Spyro. A dark, foreboding place in which Cinder broods and skulks and plans her next assault. You must make your way to her fortress, where I'm sure Ignitus is being held.
Next time I say that I want to face Cinder, why don't you go ahead and punch me in the mouth?
No problem. Ignitus is waiting.
Spyro. Spyro.
What?
I don't like this. It feels like she's baiting us. I'm getting smarter.
Spyro! Destroy the crystal! Quickly!
Let's get him out of here before Cinder gets back.
If only it were that easy, little one.
So big.
Time you learned how complicated life can be.
Run! Spyro! Save yourself!
Not this time. This time I fight.
Bring it. It's so sad it must end this way. Now, where was I?
Does she ever use doors?
There was something in her eyes, Ignitus. Something familiar.
There should be, Spyro. You and Cinder share more than you know. It's time I told you the truth. All of it. You see, after I took your egg to the Silver River, I returned to the grotto to find utter chaos. The other guardians had been overrun, and all the other eggs had been smashed by the Dark Master's forces. All except one. You see, the Dark Master was torn. He wanted to destroy all the eggs to prevent the birth of the Purple Dragon. But he also needed a dragon.
Why would he need a dragon?
Because, Spyro, Only one born in the year of the dragon could open the portal that served as the Dark Master's prison.
Cinder?
I'm afraid so.
But if we come from the same place, why is she so... so...
evil? Monstrous? Big? Sexy? Oops, did I say that?
Because, Spyro, after the night of the raid, she was corrupted by the Dark Master's poisonous powers, twisted by his evil lore. She's become the Dark Master's monster.
But why? What does this Dark Master want?
He wants to be freed from the portal of convexity, to wreak havoc across the realms. And if Cinder gets there, he just might succeed. I'm afraid we might be too late.
No, I refuse to give up. I'm going to stop Cinder and the Dark Master.
Wait, you heard the dragon, Spyro. He said, too late. We'll get him next time. Come on, champ. You did a great job, and let's take five.
No, I'm ready. Now!
Okay. Okay, Spyro, you're right. At the very least, you have to try. If the Dark Master escapes, a shadow will fall over the land. And who knows what will happen then. May the ancestors look after you. May they look after us all. Convexity acts as an airlock between our world and the dark realms beyond. You must stop Cinder before she inserts the final crystal and activates the portal, freeing the Dark Master.
I have a feeling you're gonna see a whole lot more. Come on.
My master returns.
We're too late.
Persistent little fellow, aren't you? This is where it really ends.
Bring it!
No mercy this time.
I can't watch this.
Oh, she is just like me.
Dude, we gotta get out of here now.
I can't leave her behind. I've got to save her.
What? Save the beast that's been trying to kill us?
Yeah, that wasn't her fault. She was being used by the Dark Master. Now we can go.
I'm right behind you, buddy.
Mommy, fluff my pillow.
Feeling better, Spyro?
Not really, Ignitus. That battle drained every last bit of my strength. I can hardly lift my head.
Yes, it will take some time for your powers to return. But they will in time, young dragon. They will in time. Cinder, ever since I failed the night of the raid, I've dreamt of this day.
It wasn't just you, Ignitus. We all failed.
Be that as it may, we're together again now. thanks to Spyro. Well done, young dragon.
Thanks, Ignitus. But we still don't know what's happened to the Dark Master.
No matter, Spyro. There will be time to talk of the Dark Master later. Now it's time to be grateful for your success.
His success? Hey, what about me? Just because a bunch of weird stuff doesn't fly out of my mouth doesn't mean I didn't help you now.
Yeah, you were a big help, Sparks. No doubt about it. But just for the record, a lot of weird stuff does come out of that little mouth of yours.
And what the heck is that supposed to mean? You know, I don't need this. I could have stayed with the llama people, whatever, where I was appreciated, but no. Now I decided to help the poor, helpless dragons rid the world of evil. What a mistake that was, because I get no thanks. No respect, no love, no credit.
My goodness. And I thought Voltaire talked a lot.
I left home too, you know. I'm a little guy, yeah, that's right. Maybe you haven't noticed. Things are a lot bigger to me than they are to you. And did I back away? Uh-uh. Nah, nah, nah. Why? Because I got moxie. I'm a tough cookie. I got class. I got a little frog in my throat. As I was saying, on tall plains, they knew a good thing when they saw it. They recognized the value of a quality dragonfly like me. But here I get nothing. Not even a thanks. Hey, how you doing? Good. Let me buy you a drink. I should go back to the swamp. Mom will make it all good. Mommy always does.
See anything, Spyro?
No. But I've got a bad feeling.
Me too.
Just like me.
We gotta get after her.
Now! I can't leave her behind. I've got to save her.
What? Save the beast that's been trying to kill us?
Yeah, that wasn't her fault. She was being used by the Dark Master. Now we can go.
Spyro! Hey, Spyro. Some night, huh? Beautiful.
What is it you want, Sparks?
Why do I have to want something? I'm just ready to begin the best day ever now that the evil psycho she-dragon is gone.
What? Cinder? What do you mean, Sparks?
Whoa, calm down, big fella. Gosh, you're awfully tense. Haven't been sleeping much? You should listen to Voltaire tell one of his stories. That'll put anyone to sleep.
Sparks, what happened?
Okay, you ready? I got up to get some fresh air. Since I don't sleep much myself these days with the female fright hanging about. Lo and behold, there she was, sneaking out into the garden. She gives me the creeps, dude. Hear my teeth?
What Come on, we have to find her. It's dangerous for her to be outside the temple at night.
It's dangerous for any of us to be outside at night. Besides, Ignitus said you have to wait till your powers return. Because you're weak.
No time to argue. Come on.
You'd be helpless without me. I better come with you.
Mustn't wake them.
What? I can't hear you over all this snoring.
Yes, of course, I'm honest.
In the truth of matter.
Cinder, what are you doing out here? It's dangerous.
You shouldn't have followed me, Spyro.
That's good enough for me. Let's go. See ya. Yeah.
Please, don't make this harder for me than it already is.
I'm just trying to understand.
I'm leaving, Spyro. I don't belong here. After all I've done, all I've put you through, I can't stay.
Cinder, nobody blames you for what happened.
Huh, I do. Speak for yourself.
Sparks.
No, Sparks is right. And every day that goes by, I'm reminded of it. Spyro, your place is here. Your destiny is here. But mine is somewhere out there for me to find.
Cinder, I don't want you to go.
Goodbye, Spyro.
Now, can we finally get some sleep around here? I've been only sort of half-sleeping with one eye open for weeks now. Alternating eyes, of course. It lessens the strain, but I tell you, it's taking a toll. Hey, was this twitch always there? Spyro, you okay, buddy? Hey, I want to sleep too, but I didn't mean now. Let's at least get inside. It's dark out, man, and I don't like it. Hello? Anyone home? Yoo-hoo!
Hello? Is anyone there?
Do not be frightened, young dragon. You are not alone.
Who are you? What is this place?
I have summoned you here so that you might be warned. The celestial moons are counting down, and time is running out.
How did that happen?
The purple dragon can wield many abilities that others cannot, including time itself. Learn to master this ability, and you will be able to see things almost before they happen. But use this gift sparingly, only when circumstances demand. Manipulation of time is not to be done without the uttermost care. You seem to have abandoned your true calling. It is your destiny to harness the powers of the elements, and yet you possess not.
I haven't been able to use my abilities for some time now.
Yes. Right now, your powers lay dormant within you. Let's see if we might not awaken them.
Clear your mind, Spyro, and feel the fire that flows through your veins. Allow its heat to consume you, and breathe with it. Now, rise up, and release the firestorm.
Spyro, you're a natural.
You have done well. And now? It is time for you to return, but be careful, Spyro. The enemy approaches.
Wait! You still haven't told me who you are.
You shall know me as the Chronicler. Seek me out.
Hello? 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 Anyone home? Hello? Hello?
Something is happening, Sparks. I can't explain it.
No kidding. While you were catatonic, this whole place has been hooting and howling. Listen.
What is that? What's happening? Temple is under attack. The others are still sleeping. We need to get back.
Are you crazy? Do you want to run towards the danger?
We're going to have to find another way in. Come on.
Ugh, I liked you better when you were sleeping.
The purple dragon.
Ugly ape guy. Now that we've exchanged pleasantries, can we fight? Or if it's you two to fight, now what?
Get down here, young dragon. We need your help.
Officer, attention on the top of the garden.
This one, fella.
This one? How is that different than the last one? Or the one before that?
Prepare to die!
Huh? Is it something about preparing to die? The battery wants you to repair a pie. Yeah. Yeah.
You haven't seen the last of me!
I'm just going to assume you said it was great meeting you, and have a nice day, in which case we thank you.
Is everyone all right? Where's Cinder? See anything, Ignitus?
No. I can't see where Cinder has gone. Just darkness.
Wait. Cinder, darkness. Aren't they the same thing?
What's this? Something is coming into focus. This is peculiar. I see you at the base of a great tree, amidst a lake of mist and gloom.
A tree? I've seen that tree, in my dreams. Only, they usually feel more like nightmares.
Young dragon, you've been keeping secrets. What is it you see in these dreams of yours?
I'm sorry, Ignitus. I thought they would go away, but they only get worse.
Relax, Spyro. Think.
I keep seeing a mountain draped in shadow. A face of stone beneath two moons. And darkness.
The Mountain of Malifor.
Whoa! Am I the only one that thought that was weird?
There was another, but it was more like I was seeing into the past and the future all at once. And there was a voice, calling himself the Chronicler. That's when I saw the tree.
Impossible.
Yeah, no kidding. There isn't even a storm.
The Chronicler?
What? Don't encourage him.
I don't believe it either. I've not heard that name in ages.
Nor has anyone. But there is no way that Spyro could have known. This is fascinating.
Who is the Chronicler?
The Chronicler is an ancient dragon of immeasurable wisdom. Though I've only heard stories. In fact, I've had my doubts as to the legitimacy of the tale. Yet now, I am left to wonder.
As are we all. But if it is true, it is unsettling that the re-emergence of the Chronicler would coincide with an attack on the temple. Not to mention these other visions that Spyro was having.
Yes, very. Tales of the Chronicler are often interwoven with tales of doom.
Oh, goody! I was afraid we might have to spend the rest of the night without any more doom.
It was only a matter of time, Ignitus. We've all felt it. A great evil is on the horizon.
Perhaps. But we mustn't rush to judgment. This evening has brought about many unexplained things.
We may not have time, Ignitus. The celestial moons are almost at an eclipse. This we know for certain.
We must prepare for the worst. The night of eternal darkness draws nigh.
If nigh means soon, I'm out of here.
Your instincts, though faint of heart, are true. We are no longer safe here. This recent attack is likely the first of many. The forces of the Ape King know of Spyro's existence and will not rest until they witness his demise.
demise. Hate to be you. What? You guys need to lighten up.
I'm afraid Terador is right. As uncertain as things are, none of us can remain idle and watch our worst fears unfold before us.
Exactly. We need a good hiding place.
Voltier, you and Cyril must go to the mainland to learn what news you can. Terador, make haste to the Shattered Vale and warn the inhabitants of that region that darkness is spreading in Malifor. I shall stay back and search for Cinder. These are dangerous times for a dragon to be wandering about. May our ancestors look after us and keep us safe in these dark times.
What should I do, Ignitus?
Young dragon, you must travel by another path and seek out the tree from your dream. If the stories of the Chronicler are true, there may be hope for us yet. And I think I know where to begin.
There is an ancient grove within the forest at the end of the Silver River. It is a secret place untouched by civilization. The waters there are poisonous, as well as the creatures who are notified, but you shouldn't encounter any real danger. Trust your instincts. I shall be waiting for you here at the temple when your task is complete.
Oh, yes, lovely. He always sends us to the nicest places.
Come on, Sparks, it's not that bad.
Well, sure, if you ignore all the evil beasts and visions of doom and eternal darkness, which sounds lovely, by the way. Oh, and the fact that we now get to frolic through the magical creepy forest in search of some stupid tree? What's not to love?
You're psyched. Let's go. What are we doing here? I'm not even sure what I'm supposed to be looking for. I think we're lost.
Hey, have you tried these yet? They're delish. Come on, try some.
Sparks, don't eat that. You don't even know what it is.
Nonsense. They're perfectly edible.
All right, maggots. Time to spread out. Don't bother snaring anything smaller than a scurvy wing. Scab only wants prize fighters this time. And double the bounty for the one who captures Arboric.
Hey, this isn't right. Ignitus said this place was uninhabited. We must have taken a wrong turn.
All those in favor of turning back?
Hey, came from over there. Oh, see what it is.
Oh, not now. How is everyone today?
Little bug isn't much bigger than a boss rat.
Hey, who are you calling a bug, you crazy-eyed, mangy drool mutt?
Get him!
Mommy!
It's cold here. Chronicler? Are you there? I've done what you've asked of me, but I'm afraid I'm lost.
As long as the spirits of the ancestors are with you, you are never lost. Calm yourself, Spyro, and cool your thoughts. not let your fire control you. There are other elements at play here. The power of ice also moves through you, just as the chilled winds whip through your wings. Let it expand. I knew you'd remember. Life seeks out balance, the Undrag, and one who can master fire and ice is truly powerful in the shifting face of danger.
Okay, now what? What is it you want me to do? I think I'm entitled to know what's happening.
You already know what is happening. Of the great evil that is awakening. But there is more that you must understand.
I've seen this place before. It frightens me.
This is an evil place, Spyro. It is called the Mountain of Malifor. Asylum to the wandering phantoms and lost spirits of those who had turned to darkness. But to the spirits themselves and the black-hearted, it goes by another name.
The Well of Souls.
Sparks? Sparks, where are you?
Spyro, I'm out of shape.
What have we here? Our first catch of the day.
Is that your dumb tree? It's beautiful. Where we go now?
This feels like the right place, but I'm not sure what I'm supposed to do here.
Wonderful. I'm gonna go wait over there. You know, give you a few minutes. Maybe there was a lily pad you forgot to sing on, or a rainbow you can talk to.
Hello? I'm here. Give me a sign, or... something.
It's my turn to pass out. You're on your own, buddy.
Oh, brother.
Killed it. We came all this way so you could kill it? Spyro, I am the mighty tree calling you from across the void. Journey hither and vanquish me.
Yeah, I don't think I was supposed to do that.
Wait, you don't suppose that was the Chronicler?
Alas. The purple dragon has been wandering lost in the ancient grove. You've been quite a nuisance to us.
Whoa, what's with the gurgling nitwit?
If I were you, I'd shut my mouth. I ain't gonna say it again.
Sparks, maybe you should stay out of this one.
Yes, mind yourself. To answer your earlier question, no, that isn't the Chronicler, whoever that is. That was Arboric, and he was going to be the main attraction in our tournament. Now it's ruined.
Gosh, I really feel bad about that.
Oh, really, no need for remorse. You'll do just fine.
What does he mean by that?
Coming for to carry me home.
Sparks, must you do that?
Well, maybe I do must I do that. And you know, it might be just crazy enough to work. Come on, Spyro. Put that sorrow behind you and clap your hands with me. Let the joy come pouring down. Rain on me. And you... Can't you feel it? Can't you just feel the love in the room tonight?
Molière!
Sparrow? Is that really your friend?
It's me. Where are we? Can you get us out?
You are on Scamp's ship. We'll likely be made to compete in the arena fights like the other prisoners. I am a prisoner here, as are many of my kinsmen. But the rules are required to make for worthwhile entertainment, so we are made to serve grog to the scavengers.
Molière, you have to get us out.
Shh! We'll talk later.
I trust your living quarters if you like them.
I don't know. My roommate could be more fun, though.
I thought I told you to be quiet, fool! And you, get ready to fight! It's hurting time, babe!
I mean more than really, I hate those birds.
Fiends and felons! Scoundrels and swindlers, welcome to the first event of the evening. Tonight we bring to you a very special battle, sure to quench your thirst for brutality.
Enough of this zibber-jab. Let's bring on the main.
Introducing a creature both rare and powerful. A creature of might and magic. Prepare yourselves and feast your eyes on Spyro the Dragon!
Wow, if we weren't about to die, I'd say this is pretty neat. Ah, that's the butterflies in your stomach. Trust me, I know.
And his opponent, you've seen them before, and loved them. We offer you none other than the twins of terror themselves, the Blundertales.
Great crowd, huh? I wonder if I can get them to do the wave.
Well done. Well done indeed. Step forward, little dragon, and receive your glory.
You waiting for something to move for you, bud? Don't just stand there. This ain't no puppet show.
Oh, no, not again. Don't worry. There's nothing to see here. It's all under control. And allow me to entertain you with the healing power of love while we wait. Swing low. I don't hear you. Come on. Swing low. Sweet, what's the matter with you all?
You stink!
You've come far, young dragon.
What? Ignitus said you would help, but you've only led me on a path to nowhere.
Our path through life is not always the path we choose. Sometimes our paths are chosen for us, and it is our destiny to follow it wherever it may lead. Be steady, Spyro. And use the power of the earth to feel your way. The power of earth and nature is a mighty one. For as the earth moves, so does everything in it. Be mindful as you wield it.
I want to know what is happening. I've done what you've asked of me and followed your path.
Yes, but a time will come when you will have to choose your own path. And you are not ready. Open your eyes.
Why are they going towards it?
It is their calling. The black-hearted creatures of this world cannot resist its temptation. The Well of Souls beckons them as the Night of Eternal Darkness approaches.
What is the Night of Eternal Darkness?
It is the night when the celestial moons come together in a great eclipse. It shrouds our world in darkness. The Well of Souls is the pinnacle of its terrible shadow, stirring the spirits of the deceased from their eternal rest and permitting them to roam freely within the halls of the mountain, if only for a short while. And soon, the Night of Eternal Darkness will be upon us. Find me in the celestial caves of the White Isle.
Get up, lazy fool! It's time to bruise, not time to snooze! I can't even look at you. You disgust me.
Hey! You and me both, Pally.
Don't touch me!
Are you ready for more? Then, without further ado, please give a hearty welcome to Spyro the Dragon! And his opponent, needing little introduction,
Captain the Crunch, the Prince of Aid himself!
The one and only Rabbit Rider!
We totally rule! Maybe now we can ask for a room upgrade. Can we at least order some room service?
Sparks, we need to get out of here. Something terrible is going to happen.
I know. If I don't get some food, I am gonna freak out. I got it! Why don't you shoot some sparkling magic out of your face and blow the gate up?
Sparrow, you are in danger! I have a message for you from another prisoner. Here, take it.
Yahoo! Fan mail!
Dear friend, there are whispers going about the ship. Word of your captivity has traveled quickly. Many of the prisoners are uneasy. They say that the Ape King himself has placed a bounty on you, and all of the dragons. These are dark times, but know this, you have allies. I look forward to the day when we can meet. Hunter of Avalon.
That was thoughtful. I particularly like the part about the dark times and the danger.
It's showtime.
Guests of the arena, we have exciting news for you regarding one of our combatants. Shall we bring him out? There is a rumor about that this little purple dragon may be of great importance. What say you, dragon? What greatness can you offer?
You're the thing great you've been sold us. It's great things!
Bring out the executioner! Well, well, it appears we are amongst greatness. This little dragon has defeated everything we've thrown at him. But let's not, you faithful fans. Tonight, we have a special bonus match.
Cool, a bonus match!
Spyro the Dragon versus the former Queen of Konkar herself, Cinder!
I told you she was evil. Look, my eyes twitching again.
Just like old times, huh, Spyro?
Cinder, I'm not going to fight you.
Relax. I'm just trying to put on a show for the crowd while we figure out what to do.
Don't trust her. She wants to eat me.
What's happening?
I want out! I want in!
Get away from me! Help!
Bender!
Spyro, this way! There's an opening!
I think things just got more complicated.
Good. I was afraid that escaping the burning ship would be too easy.
Moliere, the ship's under attack. We have to get off this thing.
Spara, please! My companions are still being held prisoner and the chamber gates are locked! We'll need to find a way to open them.
Okay, sit tight. I'll come back for you. Okay, Moliere, you're safe. Get far away from here.
Merci, mon frère. Thank you very much. I hope we can meet again. Perhaps under better circumstances?
Good luck, Moliere.
Hey, that guy just gave me an idea. Why don't we get off the burning boat?
Not yet. We need a map to a place called the White Isle, and I think I know where we can find them.
You know I hate you, right?
Whoa, look at all this stuff.
Oh, sure, take your time. It's not like we're about to plummet to our deaths in a heap of flaming...
All right, you made your point. Find the map.
One step ahead of you, buddy.
Well, it isn't a purple menace.
We hope you weren't thinking of me.
Yeah, we got a score to settle, chump.
Hey, who are you calling chump?
You, fool! You!
It's astounding the amount of trouble you've managed to call.
You've only brought it on yourself.
You gonna let him talk you that way, Doodle Rain? Shut up, fool! Fire the cannon!
This is where we part ways.
So long, chump!
How is that even possible?
We can't just let them get away. We're going after them, right? Wait, did I just say that on top? You don't know us very well. I quit all the time. Sorry, I thought it was gonna sound cooler. Did you see me back there? I was like, bam! And he was all, which reminds me, where are we going?
I didn't get a very long look at the map, but there's gotta be some sort of landmark.
Sure. I'll just keep my eyes peeled for the flashing sign that says Spooky Moon Temple. Oh no. Please tell me you're just pulling over to go to the bathroom.
Dark here. Can you hear me? Is anyone there? I want to know what has happened to Cinder.
A flash of lightning is born of the sky and its tempers, young dragon. You must learn to control your own emotions if you are to tame the free spirit of electricity. Erratic nature. Allow its energy to charge through your body and anticipate its movement. Then unleash it willingly. Accentuated by your impulsive nature. Trust your instincts, Spyro.
Okay, I've completed your test. What do I do next? How can I find you? Are you there? Great. Now the voice inside my head is ignoring me. Maybe I'll just take a peek.
stands.
You can't go through with this, Gaul.
Nothing can prevent this. We are merely here to welcome our master back into the realm and join him at his side. But fear not, Cinder. You've been such a faithful servant. I'm sure he'll take you back. And if not, you will have the honor of being the first to perish by his hand. Long have we waited. Long have we suffered. But soon, our master will return, and his coming shall bring forth a new age of power for the apes, and we shall have our revenge.
Goodbye, freaky little turtle monster. Goodbye, goodbye. Thanks for everything.
What happened?
Well, let's see. You've been hearing voices in your head and have led us all over the place, which has been great because we're having so much fun. And now we're stranded on an enchanted island, and I just can't wait to see what happens next.
Wait. I think we're here.
Oh, goody.
Sacred Threshold. Hollow ground, have risen full, lost is found. Prove your worth with quick desire, ice and earth, electric fire.
What the? Now I'm hearing voices.
What does that mean?
How would I know? Wait, I'm having a thought. Nope. Yeah, nope, never mind. I lost. I got nothing.
We must have missed something. Come on, let's look around. Hold on. I think we found it. Hello? Is anyone there?
Hey, if there is, could we, you know, not wake it up? Because everything we've met so far has tried to kill us.
Expose your heart to summon ghost. Then face alone what you fear most.
I knew it! This place wants us dead. We should have turned back while we had a chance.
I need to do this, Sparks.
Yeah? Go ahead, expose your heart and see what happens. Wait, don't do it! You can't leave me behind in the wacky moon temple, with all the whispering walls and the crawly thingies! They want to make me part of their freak show! Go first. Ooh, what's this? I think it's a magic wishing lamp. Hello? Genie? You in there?
This is incredible. The entire history of the dragon race. It looks like it's all here.
It is. Well, most of it.
That? It spoke to me!
The records in this hall date back to the beginning of time. Nearly.
The Chronicler!
Yes, Spyro. It is I. And I've been waiting for you.
Oh, well. I hope we didn't keep you waiting too long. We got a little held up back there with the, well, you know.
Riddles of Doom!
It was a necessary evil. I had to be sure, Spyro. I haven't had any visitors in my solitude for over 1,000 years.
Shocker! Try getting rid of the psychedelic dragon outside!
You've been here for that long?
Oh, yes.
But I have my books, and I watch and wait, and listen for things to come, and then add them to the books of time. You are also written in the books, though many pages are still left incomplete.
I am? Can I see?
Of course you can. This one is yours. Look. You've seen this hideous creature before.
Why is he in my book?
It was Gaul who led the raid on the temple the night of your birth, when Ignitus rescued your egg.
And when they took Cinders.
Yes. That was most unfortunate. Oh, and look, here is Little Sparks.
Hey, nobody needs to see that. Ever.
Wait, can these books tell the future?
In parts, though. Just glimpses of the future, really.
Then I want to know what will happen to Cinder.
Sparrow, you don't know...
Please! I must know.
Very well, but hers is a darker tale. Sparrow, you must understand, when she was taken by Gaul, she was poisoned and corrupted, made to do the Dark Master's bidding. Her entire life has been spent in shadow. She knows no other way. And when the Dark Master returns, she will concede. No one can resist the temptation. Not even the strongest among us.
I don't believe that.
Sparrow, let me tell you another story.
Ooh, ooh, ooh! Can I pick the story this time?
There was once a dragon, long ago, whose raw power was far greater than anyone had ever seen or could imagine. At first, he mastered fire, which was odd because he was not a fire dragon. Then came ice and wind and other abilities none thought possible. Is this story sounding familiar?
It was a purple dragon, like me.
The first purple dragon. In the beginning, he was encouraged, and secrets of elemental mastery were passed on to him willingly by the elders. But his power was limitless. It knew no boundary. He consumed everything. When he would not stop, he was cast into exile. And from his new fortress within the mountain, he built an armor, not of dragons, but of apes, and taught them to artificially harness the power of the gems, our life force.
You're talking about the Dark Master.
Yes. And in his dark seclusion, the sheer weight of his malice cracked the very foundation of the mountain, splitting the earth, creating a pit of despair where the lost souls of this world could reside.
The Well of Souls.
Created by the very beast who now seeks to escape it.
But you said that the eclipse would only allow the spirits to escape for a short while.
Yes, but if there was ever a spirit powerful enough...
Then how do we stop it?
There is no stopping it. It has been written.
Then why have you called us here? I don't understand.
To ride out this storm, where you'll be safe. Live to fight another day.
Well, that sounds pretty good.
What about the others? What about their safety?
I fear the worst for the others.
And Cinder? Am I supposed to sit here and do nothing while she joins them?
Let me field this one. Yes!
No. You keep talking about choosing a path. But what about Cinder? She was never given a choice. I have to try. I'm going, and you can't stop me.
Then I won't. Young dragon, I've waited far too long to watch you leave here stricken with grief and doubt. You'll need a clear mind and a pure heart if you are to withstand the evil that consumes that place.
I know this is not the path you would choose for me, but I have to walk my own path and do what I know is right.
So be it, Sparrow. I will show you the way, but you must hurry. The dark hour of the eclipse is near, and haste will be your only ally.
All right, then. Well, just so I know why I died... The plan is to wander into the land of darkness to face an army of evil creatures that will want to kill us so we can try to rescue another evil creature that has already tried to kill us? I'm pumped! Let's do this.
Sparks, you don't need to come with me. I won't think less of you if you stay behind.
No way! And miss the opportunity to live out my worst nightmares? Yeah, boy. What am I saying?
What is this?
It looks like the entrance to a horrible pit of despair, of which we will probably never escape. But we should probably go inside to be sure. Whoa!
He's so weird. Where are we?
The better question is, what's that smell?
To the dawn of a new age and the failure of your pathetic race of dragons.
I wouldn't miss it, Dahl.
Then please have a seat. Foolish dragon, you are no match.
I've made it this far, haven't I?
Yes, you have been quite elusive. Had I but known that all it would take would be your miserable amity for Cinder.
What's Amity?
How tragic, really. That she should be the one to destroy you.
Ah! The nightmare never ends!
You don't need to do this, Cinder.
Just like old times, huh, Spyro? Same as last time. Line me up with a staff.
Don't touch him. The whelpling is mine. Dragon.
I done?
You're okay, Spyro. You're with friends.
I'm sorry. I couldn't stop.
Oh, that's our only way out!
Come on, now's our chance!
Just go.
Get up, Spyro. We're not leaving without you.
Usually, I would say ignore her, but she's making sense this time.
No, we're trapped!
Ride out this storm and live to fight another day.
Get close to me! Now!
Young dragon, all our hope now lies with you. When you wake up, it will be a different world. But know this, you are not alone. You have allies.
Even in the darkest of times, there is always hope. But sometimes fear clouds our vision. Sometimes our strength gives out. And yet sometimes when all seems lost, a light shines through the darkness. And we are reminded that even the smallest amount of courage can turn the tides of war.
Open your eyes. Get up.
Cinder, what happened? Where are we?
I don't know. It's all a blur.
Yeah, me too. My head's pounding.
Shh, wait. That's not your head. I hear it too.
What is that? Sparks, is that you?
For once, I wish it was. What are they doing?
Let's not stick around to find out. Come on!
Oh, what is your problem? Oh, this can't be good.
Slowing us down. We can't fight it. We'll have to move in unison. Follow my lead.
Why should you lead?
Uh-oh. Take cover!
Okay, good idea. You lead.
Sparks! It's good to see you too. You okay?
You know, a little stiff. Voice keeps changing, but I'm good.
Hey, this reunion is really touching and everything, but shouldn't we be going? Unless you want to wait for that thing to climb back up. I hate to think what it might do to Sparks.
Who is he?
I don't know. All he said was,
"Shh, you're making too much noise."
I like him already.
Spyro, Cinder, how do you feel? Anything broken?
Shaken a little, but not too badly, thanks to you.
I am relieved. I had feared I might be too late. My name is Hunter.
Hunter? You've been tracking me.
For far too long, friend. When you didn't return to the temple, the Elder Dragon, Ignitus, sent me to find you. That was nearly 3 years ago.
What? 3 years? But that's impossible.
Yes. I'm sure this news comes as quite a shock. Forgive me for the brevity of my explanation, but this is not the place to account for missing time. We are not safe here. Follow me.
You go first, Cinder. It's safer.
Give us a moment to gather our strength.
You might want to stand back. This can get weird.
It is fascinating how your kind draws strength from these crystals. Dragons are truly remarkable.
Yeah, you say that now, till one tries to kill you. And by one, I mean her.
I am aware of Cinder's past, but Ignitus trusts her. And that's good enough for me.
Go on, Cinder.
Spyro, as a rare purple dragon, you can wield many abilities that others cannot. Now it is time to awaken these powers within you. Fire, electricity, ice, and earth. Cinder, while most other dragons can master only a single element, your exposure to the darkness has gifted you with abilities most uncommon. Poison, fear, wind, and shadow.
There's a light up there. We must be getting close. What is that? I've never seen one like that before.
Spyro, be careful.
It isn't natural. That crystal radiates with dark magic. Destroy it quickly. The horn. It must be part of some sort of locking mechanism. This way, quickly.
What was that thing?
There'll be time for that. We'll follow the river. It will lead us to shelter where we can rest. And then, we're off to Warfang, the Dragon City, where Ignitus will be expecting us.
Maybe if we try twisting it.
Twist what? It's magic.
I can watch this all day.
The Dark Master. He's returned, hasn't he?
I'm afraid so. just shortly after your disappearance. He struck quickly, fueled by hatred and malice, reclaiming the throne at the temple, which, through some dark magic, he now suspends above the land, a symbol of his dominance. We've been at war ever since, and every day, his forces grow stronger, and ours lose hope.
They were all counting on me, and I failed. How could I let this happen?
Some things are beyond your control. You shouldn't blame yourself.
Spyro, you are lucky to be alive. All of you. That was no ordinary creature back there. It was an ancient Earth golem from the deep. They are the embodiment of destruction summoned by Malifor himself. These are dark times.
He needs to be stopped. I have to stop him.
Whoa. Slow down, tough guy. You don't need to go around picking fights. I mean, we just woke up after being frozen for 3 years. Got stuff to do. What the? Is she sleepy? Hey!
No!
Such little respect for our laws that you form an alliance with the very ones who caused all our misfortunes.
Chief Prowlis, Malifor, he alone is the one responsible. This dragon is our last hope. You must see that.
Yes, the purple dragon. I know this story, but unlike you, I have not forgotten what they say Malifor was like when he was young, and I have not forgotten either what she has done. I relied on you, Hunter, as I must rely on all of us in this village to protect it. But you chose to abandon us and bring the dangers of the outside world with you when you returned.
The dangers are already around us. Don't pretend to ignore them.
Hey, can't you guys just stop arguing? It's getting awkward for everybody.
Rublin! In the valley! Repair your weapons!
See what you've done?
Let us go. We can help.
Our warriors can handle this.
Now is not the time to be stubborn.
Hey, a lot of weird stuff happens when they get upset. I'd listen to them if I were you.
We are saved! Woo! Ah! Because of a dragon, we are all gonna die!
Is everyone all right?
No. Meadow is missing. He had gone upstream to search for herbs this morning and has not returned. We have to go find him.
No, it's too dangerous to mount a search now.
I'll go. I'll find your missing friend. Hunter can come with us.
You are free to act as you see fit, but Hunter stays here. However, if you remain true to your word and come back with Meadow, I may reconsider. And don't bother returning before then, as you'll likely succeed only in attracting more grublins to our village.
Thank you, friends. You saved my life.
Finally, some gratitude. You're welcome.
You've met Chief Prowlis, no doubt. Not all of us are of the same mind.
Well, that's putting it mildly, isn't it?
Can you move? We need to get you out of here.
I'm sorry, I'm afraid my leg is broken. Just go back to the village and tell them where I am.
Your leader doesn't trust us. If we return without you, he'll likely assume the worst.
Yeah, and blame us for it.
Oh, the fool. I understand. There is a raft at the far end of the valley. If you could bring it here, perhaps I could pull myself onto it.
Okay, we'll do it.
To launch it, you'll need the weights from the supply cave, but it's locked.
Oh, that figures.
There is a hermit who lives beneath the waterfall at the other end of the valley. He has a key, but the cave is hidden. Look for the markings on the wall to open the path.
Oh, easy. Raft, cave, Obama, Got it. Yes.
We'll come back for you. I promise. What do you mean? I've never been here before.
Not you. The female.
You must be mistaken.
Indeed. Your appearance has changed, but not your eyes. Your eyes give everything away. You are the Black Dragon. Cinda, the terror of the skies. The Dark Master's puppet.
I was, but I'm not anymore. I'm not proud of the things I've done.
Oh, is it that simple to turn your back on Malifaux?
You don't have to listen to him, sir.
Did you not recognize the creatures that moved in the shadow? The apes too had served the Dark Master, but more for their own greed and thirst for power than any true loyalty to him. This is how Malifaux repaid them. Doomed to remain in the dark, feeding off the power of others, never being fulfilled. You can run. But you cannot find Cinder.
Cinder, let's go.
The Dark Master will find you.
Cinder, are you okay?
I'm fine. I'll be fine.
Well, I am not. Was I the only one who was freaked out by that guy? Jeez. Okay, at least it wasn't a complete waste of time. Ta-da! Come on, what you waiting for?
You've come back. Thank you.
Oh, yeah. It was really no problem at all. I did all the work. I'm just kidding.
Let's get you home.
Meadow,
how did
I will be fine, thanks to these two dragons.
Meadow, please forgive me. These dragons willingly sought to help you, when I chose not to. I do not share your faith in this dragon hunter. By putting you in chains, I committed an error.
We all make mistakes.
Yes, and I shall try to atone for mine, if you will permit me. Use the forbidden tunnel. It would lead you directly to the Dragon City. If this dragon is indeed our last hope, then I bid you safe passage, and good luck.
We could use your help. Very well. The invitation shall be left open. Meet me here as soon as you are ready to set out for Warfang. I shall be waiting for you. If we march quickly, we shall reach the Dragon City by daybreak.
Yeah, thanks for answering.
I feel vibrations in the earth. We must be getting close.
Finally!
I've never seen the Dragon City before.
It was built long ago by the Moles in honor of their friendship with the dragons. Before Malifor, dragons were quite revered. I heard it too. Quickly! It has begun. This way. Stay close. I'm all right, but you won't be able to get through this way. Go, find Ignitus.
Okay, good luck.
Spyro, please
help us!
Spyro, look!
They need our help.
Oh, Spyro, help!
Thank you. Thank you, you saved our lives.
No big deal, risking our lives, saving people, dodging danger, taking it to the man. It's an occupation.
Look out! Siege engines! They're sending in their war machines!
Listen to me. Everyone who can still fight must go to the ramparts.
The rest of you, run! Get undercover!
Okay, wait, putting out fires is one thing, but... Hey! Wait for me!
Destroy the catapult! It's our only chance against the battering ram! It's gonna shoot! Just keep it up!
Thank you.
This is odd. Why are they retreating when they were so close to taking the city?
Why aren't they retreating when they're so close? Who cares?
I feel it too. Something's not right.
They're turning around! Look!
Hush, little baby, don't say a word. Mama's gonna find you. A big monster wants to kill me.
It's in the earth beneath us! All of you, run! Run!
The city is burning. See what you can do about it. Voltaire, try to distract its vision. Terador, follow me. We'll attack it head on.
Spyro, Cinder, go and find shelter. Leave us to deal with this.
What are we going to do?
What do you mean, what are we gonna... Didn't you just hear Hunter?
We're not leaving. We can stop this.
Ignore me at your peril.
It's up to us. If we don't stop it now, it will destroy everything.
All right. I'm with you.
Why? Why do I keep going along with this?
Ignite us.
Young dragon,
You never cease to amaze me.
We never lost hope that you would return. Ignitus made sure of that.
I should have come back sooner. I let you all down. But that won't happen again.
Spyro, you've done more than anyone could expect of a dragon your age. What matters now is that you are here. And what's more, you've returned with your companions.
Well, it's not like I've really had much of a choice in the matter, seeing as how we're stuck together.
Interesting. This device is foreign to me. Mason, what do you make of this?
Never have I seen such a thing. It has the mark of evil.
Likely crafted by Malifor himself. I fear we shall not be able to remove it.
What? But there has to be a way.
How can we fight back if we're made to fight like this?
Spyro, Cinder, you have done well to get this far despite this. Do not view this chain as a hindrance, but allow it to be a reminder of the bond you two share. Your destinies are now intertwined, and that thought is a hopeful one.
Momentum has swung to our side, Ignitus. Perhaps this victory will mark a turning point in this war.
I'd like to believe that.
Citizens of Warfang, congratulations. You shall be the first to witness the resurrection of the Destroyer and the end of the world.
Malifor. What is that?
The Destroyer has commenced its journey to form a reanimation. The belt of fire will spread across the surface of this room in a torrent of fire bash. There will be no escape.
A Destroyer? But that's impossible.
Ignitus, I don't understand.
Nor do I. The ancients believed that this creature brings about the birth of a new world.
See? That sounds like a good thing.
By issuing its destruction.
Oh.
The beast moves too quickly. We can't possibly catch up with it. To set out in pursuit would be useless.
Then we shall wait for it to come back. And intercept it before it completes its circle. We must pass underground. If we are to possess the element of surprise. Besides, it is our only hope of getting into position in time without allowing Malifor to know the city has been left unguarded.
These doors were built as an exit to our city, not for going back in. They have to be opened from the inside.
Spyro, Cinder, we will assemble the troops at the main gates, but we're counting on you to get them open.
But you must hurry. Time is against us.
Whoa, is that supposed to be you?
They're all worshipping you. That isn't me. It's Malifor. Look at this place. The ancestors must have trained him here.
We are getting closer. I know what you are thinking, Spyro. Have no worry, young dragon. We'll make it.
I don't understand. Malifor is about to destroy everything. But you seem so calm.
I don't imagine Nala 4 would expend all this effort if he did not feel threatened.
But why should he?
Throughout our history, there is only known to have been two purple dragons. Like Malifor, your powers go far beyond what you might imagine. He knows this. Malifor could have accomplished anything, but instead chose evil. And the world has been spiraling in chaos ever since. Your existence is nature's way of balancing itself.
But the ancestors thought Malifor was going to be different. They believed in him. And look what happened.
Malifor draws his powers from destruction. Destruction is the only way he knows, Spyro.
Why should I be any different?
Because I know you. And your heart would not allow it. Because I believe you are destined for great things. To bring about a new age. An age of peace. And I do not see what role destruction will have in that age. Here we are.
Keep it up, Sparks. I think it's working.
Sparks, cut it out. Now's not the time.
It's never a good time.
How long until it crosses the Belt of Fire?
We might have until midday. Maybe less at that speed.
Spyro, how deep do you think that canyon is?
I don't know. What are you getting at?
What? What are you looking at? Do I have something in my... Is that in my teeth?
Cinder, you're a genius!
I have my moments.
Ignitus, can you stall it long enough to allow us to open the floodgate? If we fill up the canyon with water, it may slow it down enough to give us a fighting chance.
That may work.
Listen to me! We must prevent that monster from escaping the canyon, no matter the cost. Every moment counts.
You heard the dragon. Let's move!
We will do all we can to give you time. The rest is up to you.
The rest is up to you. Psst, pressure anything.
Let's hope this is enough.
Attack the destroyer!
for your subtleties, young dragons. You certainly know how to triumph with flair.
What's happening to it?
I don't know. It's most peculiar. No. This can't be.
Ignitus, what do we do?
There is no more that can be done. Listen to me. Not much time is left. Everyone must get to shelter.
What about the outlying populations? And there are countless still inside Dragon City. They need to be warned.
The underground city. Ignitus, there are endless caves down there. We saw them. We can lead them there.
No. I need you and Cinder here with me. Hunter, send your falcons to the outlying regions and tell them to get beneath the surface, as deep as they can. Go! All of you!
I know you're up to something, Ignitus. I've known you for too long.
Go to the others, Terador. There will be panic and disorder. A strong leader will be needed. I'll find my way back once I get Spyro and Cinder through the Belt of Fire.
We have to confront Malifor, don't we?
I see no other way. The belt is weakened, and this may be our only chance to break through.
Yeah, if we aren't incinerated first.
Oh, come on, it doesn't sound so bad. We've been through worse, right?
Sparks, you can't come with me.
What? But I always go with you.
Spyro was right. You wouldn't survive in there.
You need to make sure the others reach the underground city in time. You've been there before. You can guide them.
It's important, Sparks.
But you need me.
Right now, there are others that need you more.
Cinder, you have to promise me you will look after him. We've been through a lot together.
I promise.
Be careful, Sparks.
Hey, it's me. Being careful is all I know.
I should be able to offer some protection from the heat. Stay close to me.
Ignitus, let's turn back. There's got to be another way.
Spyro, Cinder, I have never done right by either of you. Allow me to do this.
What are you saying?
My path ends here, but yours lies beyond this. Draw strength from each other and follow your heart. It will never fail you. Now go. Go. Go!
Ignitus! No!
Spyro, stop! It's too late. You can't do anything for him now.
No, he isn't gone!
Spyro, let it go.
No!
No! Spyro, don't!
You can't stop.
You're right. Only you can do that. Please, Spyro, don't do this. We have to go on. He wanted us to.
It wasn't supposed to be like this. I feel so alone.
You're not alone. Up there somewhere, isn't it? I don't know if I can go through with this.
I don't know either. But we have to.
You said it yourself. If we don't, then everything we fought for, everything we've lost, it's all been for nothing.
All right, then. I'll go. But only because I want to get rid of this chain.
Come on. The air is too thick down here with all this ash. There's probably an updraft near the volcano.
It's beautiful up here.
The tower. It must lead to Malifor's lair. Are you ready for this?
I'm scared.
Just stay close to me.
At long last, my guests arrive. Please, come in. Such determination to get here. It seems we share other qualities besides that of our color.
No, I'm nothing like you.
Do you think so? We'll get to that.
Don't listen to him, Spyro. Don't listen to anything he says.
You are so weary. Allow me to make you more comfortable. There, that's better, isn't it? At least I do for you, Sinner. After all, you've done so much for me.
You used her!
I used her, she used you. What does it matter, really?
What does he mean?
What? He doesn't know.
Tell me what?
How she lured you to well of souls. How she tricked you into freeing me.
You're lying.
I find it peculiar how you chosen to remember things. I can assure you, it was you who freed me, Spyro, and you who brought me back. And we have sinned at the fact for that.
Cinder? Is it true?
No. I don't know. I don't know anymore.
Oh, I think you do. But perhaps you don't know.
Cinder! Cinder! No!
I should have warned you. You are alone here, aren't you? You've always been alone. Still, here you are, trying so desperately to save little Ezreal, refusing to accept the true role of the Purple Dragon. I should have been told I was the first Star of God, but I assure you, there have been many. It's been the duty of our predecessors to resurrect the destroyer of the Gods of the Deep to bring about the great cleansing. This is the true nature of our kind.
No! I don't believe that!
Of course you don't. But you fulfilled your destiny nonetheless. In my time, I was stopped, prevented from completing my quest. But you have carried the flame, yet from your own limit, and soon the world will be destroyed, you along with it.
No. Because you've left me nothing to fight for.
There's always something.
So be it.
Has begun!
just hang on.
I'm so sorry.
Don't be. It's over now.
So this is it?
Spyro, when a dragon dies, he does not truly leave this world. His spirit lives on, binding itself with nature, offering hope for the future.
I know what I need to do. Just get out of here, Cinder.
Spyro, no! You don't have to do anything. Let's just go.
Where, Cinder? There'll be nothing left. The world is breaking apart. But I think I can stop it. I think I'm meant to.
Then I'm with you.
Be welcome, friend. I have long been expecting you. A new age is beginning. With each new age, a worthy dragon is chosen to chronicle the many triumphs and failures of that age. This has been my duty for many millennia. And now, Ignitus, I pass this honor to you.
And what of Spyro?
That is the question, isn't it? You see, each time a dragon dies, a new page is written in this book. I've done my best, but I can't seem to find any trace of Spyro.
Well, young dragon, where might you be?